In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to make the perfect bakery style eggless pineapple cake. From baking a soft and spongy cake to icing it like a pro, I'm going to show you everything in detail. Also, I'm going to be using fresh pineapple and not the tinned version. So if you are a baking enthusiast or a beginner baker, then this video is a must watch. But before I begin making this recipe, if you haven't already, then please subscribe to my channel and hit on the bell icon so that you are notified every time I upload a new video. So in this video, I'll be making a 1 kg cake and the recipe is according to that. To make the sponge, I have taken some curd in this bowl to which I'm going to add sugar, melted butter, some pineapple essence, and a few drops of vanilla essence. And I'm just going to whisk all this well till the sugar dissolves. Let it rest for 10 minutes and then we will add the other ingredients. So it has been 10 minutes and the sugar has completely dissolved. It is important to let the sugar completely dissolve because if there are small specks of sugar, they will caramelize while baking and you will get brown spots all across your cake and also the sweetness will not be even. So it's been 10 minutes and now I'm going to add the baking powder and the baking soda to this curd and whisk it well. All the lumps have to be broken down of the soda and there should be even leavening. And after this kind of vigorous beating, now I'm going to add the all-purpose flour and corn flour and slowly mix this so that all the dry ingredients have been well mixed. Add water to thin this out a little bit. Now I have not added water in the wet mix separately and I have waited to add the all-purpose flour and then added the water because sometimes the curd is watery, sometimes it is thick and we cannot predict how much water will be needed at the beginning. So always add water to thin down the batter after you've added the all-purpose flour. I have a pre-greased and dusted 7.5 inch pan and I'm just adding all the batter to it. Just tap once or twice to even out the batter and now I'm going to bake this at 180 degrees. After 30 minutes, the cake was done. And I let it rest in the baking tin for about 5 to 10 minutes and then inverted it onto this wire rack. And now this is almost at room temperature and it is ready to use. For this pineapple cake, I'm going to use fresh pineapple to make the decorations and the filling for the cake. For that, you need a fresh pineapple fruit and keep this green part intact because I'm going to use these leaves as a part of the decoration. And then with a very sharp knife, thinly slice the pineapple. We need about 5 to 6 slices of neat slices of pineapple. Ask your fruit vendor to cut the pineapple very neatly to remove all these ridges neatly. Otherwise, you will not get an even slice. Now sort out some different sizes of pineapple slices which are neat and not breaking away. To be on the safe side, just sort out about 7 or 8 of them, although we will not need all of these. We have cut them on our own and not got the slices cut from the vendor because we need very thin slices and if you get it cut from the vendor, then they cut it thick and it doesn't suit well for our decoration. if you are making cakes commercially, then you can do this step and store the pineapple in the fridge for 3 to 4 days. I am just making one cake, so only half a pineapple was actually required. So from one pineapple, you can make decoration worth of 2 1 kg cakes. And I also have some wastage here. Okay, this was the bottom part of the pineapple that didn't cut into proper slices. So that's here. And then all the extra bits that were tearing off while cutting, I'm putting it here. And this is what we will use to fill the pineapple cake with the bits of pineapple. And this is what we will use to decorate the cake with. And now I'm left with about half of this pineapple, which could be used if you were making 2 cakes. Now to make the pineapple filling, I'm just going to remove the center hard part of the pineapple because it's tough and it doesn't taste that great when it is put inside the cake as filling. In a pan, add some water and sugar and 2 drops of yellow food coloring. If you were making just the filling, then you could avoid this yellow food coloring, but I'm going to use this for decoration also, so I've added a little bit of color. The water has come to a boil and I'm now adding these pineapple slices. Don't crowd the pan too much, otherwise they will break. And now boil them till the center is slightly softened. So these pineapples are now done. Very lightly remove them from this water and drain them completely. And now I will add the chopped pineapple that will go inside the cake. Once again, cook these till they are softened. After continuous boiling, the water has slightly reduced. So I'm going to add a little bit of more water to this so that the sugar doesn't become too thick. Now this pineapple pieces are also softened and done. And I will just switch off the gas and remove all the pineapple pieces. You can also strain this. And this is the sugar syrup that we will use to moisten the sponge because it has a beautiful flavor of pineapple. I'm just going to remove it into a bowl, strain it so that any stray pieces of pineapple are caught in the strainer. And I'm going to let this cool down till room temperature and then use it. Now this is a dome silicone mold that I have, and in this I'm going to place the softened pineapple. Very carefully handle this pineapple, otherwise the petals will break. Arrange the petals because we are going to dry this pineapple, semi-dry it, not completely dry it, but dry it, so that we can use it as our decoration. Now, if you don't have the silicone mold, you can also use steel, roundish steel vatis or dal containers that we have at our houses, and place the pineapple in those. You may need to lightly grease those with very little butter so that the pineapple doesn't stick to it. And now I'm going to bake this at about 120 degrees, 100 to 120 degrees, till it becomes slightly firm and catches the shape of the pineapple, the dome, but it shouldn't be totally dry. I bake these pineapples for about 30 minutes at 150. And after that, you can see once they are slightly cool, they are holding the shape of the dome. And that is what we want. They are still flimsy, they are not dry, they still have a lot of juice, but they are just holding their shape, and that's how we want them. Now I'm going to keep them in this mold till the time I'm ready to use these pineapples so that they come completely to room temperature. Now I have whipped up some non-dairy whipping cream that comes in frozen form till this soft peak consistency so that it is easy for us to ice the cake. If you whip it till it is very hard, then it becomes difficult to decorate the cake. Trim off the top of this sponge. I'm going to divide this remaining sponge into three equal layers. And for that, I am going to first make a cut, an approximate cut, so that I have an idea along which line I need to cut this cake. So these are the three cuts. Okay, and from here onwards, I'm going to layer this cake. With a slow back and forth motion, first make the cuts all along the exteriors because the exterior is a little bit crusty and hard. And then slowly drag your knife inwards. Once it, breaks the barrier of the crust, the knife goes in much easily. Use this kind of back and forth motion and hold your knife parallel to the surface. This is the bottom layer of the sponge that we baked, and I'm going to use that as the bottom layer of the cake as well. And I'm just going to moisten the sponge, especially around the corners, because that is where the sponge is the driest. It should be lightly moistened but not soaking wet. A lot of Indian bakeries, they really soak the sponge a lot, but I like to keep the texture of the cake intact. So just lightly soak it. And then I have filled this piping bag with the icing cream that we whipped, and I'm just going to layer this cake. Now, if you want, you can do this freehand also, but doing it like this will make sure that all the icing layers are even. Spread this cream, a very, very thin layer of the cream, and then add the fruit pieces. Now, if you were to keep the fruit pieces after you have totally, applied all the cream and kept the center layer thick, then your cake will dome. The center will become domed and the cake will fall down. So by applying the fruit like this, the layering of the cake will remain even. Distribute the fruit pieces equally so that every bite has some fruit and not just the center or the sides. And now, fill in the rest of the cream. Just even out these layers. And then place the second layer on top of it. Now for the second layer, I am also going to soak this side that I will use as the bottom, that will go on top of this cream. So while keeping this in my hand, I'm going to soak this side as well, very lightly. If you will not soak this side, then this sponge will soak up all the moisture from the cream and the cake will become dry. And then slowly place this sponge on top. Apply pressure to even out the cream. So I used a hand whisk and didn't whisk it by machine, so that is why I have got very big air pockets. If you will use whisk it with the machine, then the air pockets will not be so big. in the recipe of the cake, you can adjust the sweetness. I have kept it slightly on the lesser side because of, to compensate for the sugar syrup. But if you want, you can increase the sugar a little bit in the recipe, up to 100 grams, to get the desired sweetness that you want. Now once again for the topmost layer, I will just moisten the bottom side, that is the side that will come in contact with the other layers and not the side that will come on top, because it will be difficult for the cream to glide if the sponge is moist. So in this beaker, I have kept piping hot boiling water, which we will need to ice the cake. So I'm just going to keep it to the side. And also, you will need one clean kitchen towel that is lint-free. Lint-free means it doesn't release any small fibers of cloth, because in between the icing, we need to, wipe the palette knife. And this cake napkin is to be used only for icing purposes, and it shouldn't be used for any other kitchen work and should be washed daily with hot water. So now I am just going to try to even out if all the layers are even or aligned well. They look that they are, and then smooth out the cream that has come out of these layers. I'm going to apply a thin layer of this cream to make a crumb coat. So crumb coat is when all the crumbs of the cake, we are locking those crumbs so that they don't show on the outer layer. Don't mix this excess cream with the rest of the white cream, otherwise that cream will get the color, yellow color, or the crumbs of the cake, and we don't want to spoil the remaining cream. So use a separate bowl like this to clean out your palette knife. Now the crumb coating of this cake is done. Just loosen the cake like this from the turntable, lift it, and very gently place it on this kind of clean board. And now I'm going to chill this in the freezer for 10 to 15 minutes so that this cream sets, and then we will do the second layering on top of this. This cake is now chilled for about 15-20 minutes, and I'm now going to start the second and final frosting. So I have put all the cream on top of the cake. Just dip your palette knife in piping hot water, wipe it like this so that water doesn't drip. And then just spread the cream as evenly as possible. Once again, dip the knife in hot water. Clean it off like this and brush it keeping it parallel to the surface of the cake to smoothen out. This cake doesn't need to be very smooth because we are going to finish this with a paintbrush effect. So this is how it should be. Now once again, lift this cake off the turntable. apply this light color to the sides. It's a very light green color. Now I have this kind of pastry brush, silicone pastry brush that I have dipped in hot water for a while. I'm going to dry it completely. Place it here and then just move the turntable. And I'm going to repeat this process for the top as well. And that's it. Your cake is almost done, and now we are just going to finish it off with some chocolate and pineapple decorations. Wipe this light green color in this drop formation on the top and the bottom edges of the cake to neaten it up. To make the decoration, here I have taken some white compound. And I am going to need this kind of a dome mold. If you don't have this silicone mold, then you can also use plastic tablespoons. Plastic is important, metal won't work. To make the base for the decoration, keep this chocolate slightly thick and not too liquidy. So for that, don't heat it a lot. Once you heat it for a 30-second burst in the microwave, just keep mixing it till all the chocolate dissolves. And then place a little bit of chocolate in these molds. Use the back of a spoon to spread the chocolate evenly. Make sure that the edges are not too thin, otherwise the dome will not serve our purpose. So these edges should also be thick with chocolate. You can remove the excess chocolate like this. And let the chocolate set like this. Once the chocolate has firmed up a little bit, just spread it again to thicken these sides. Now I'm going to place this in the fridge for it to chill for a while so that it is easy for us to unmold these domes. After chilling in the fridge for 15-20 minutes, it's easy to remove these chocolate domes. Place these pineapples into these molds to make flower type shapes. We are making beautiful sunflowers out of pineapple slices. Now just place some choco chips in the center to make this resemble sunflowers. So finally, place the last element on the cake, that is this pineapple sunflower. Press it in slightly, not a lot. And then lastly, just use the pineapple leaves to fill out this cake. Now these pineapple leaves have thorns, so be careful, and also they are very dirty and powdery, so wash them and clean them properly before you fix them into the cake.